The opening of a new Cornhill Test match series, a great moment in any cricketer's life and in any cricket follower's life for that matter. Welcome to Old Trafford for the first of these games. I'm afraid it was rather a damp welcome though. What happened was that the rain overnight saturated the ground and certainly saturated two of the pitches where they'd been recently seeded, and play wasn't able to begin until 2:45. That meant frustration for the players, for a lot of spectators who didn't even bother turning up, and for the umpires and the officials as well. Eventually, when the two captains went out, they announced that these were the teams to take part in this Cornhill Test match. England left out Graham Dilley. He failed a fitness test. He's had trouble with that side muscle, one that posed him problems when he was on the Australian tour. David Capel also left out of the 13. And Pakistan decided to go in with Shoaib Mohammad and Ramiz Raja to open. And they're scheduled to bat Madhusudan Azhar down in the bottom part of the order. They have Imran Khan and Wasim Akram as the opening bowlers. Mohsin Kamal is there. He might even take the new ball. Tausif Ahmed, the spinner, and Madhusudan Azhar as the extra medium pacer. Well, the toss was won by Imran Khan. He put England into bat, which indicated that he thought the rather grassless-looking pitch might contain some life. We pick up play now with the fifth ball of the second over. The bowler is Mohsin Kamal. He's coming in from the Warwick Road end. Robinson is taking strike. Already there are four runs on the board.
Well, that was just his chance there. Slipped to be just a little bit stood up and settled to carry. That's a good shot by Tim Robinson. That's his favourite stroke off the back foot. Full covers on the offside and just... Yes, it's just made the four. Probably wouldn't have done, but the fielder took the rope, the ball, and the boards all over the lot there, so no doubt about it in the end. Full length again there, and Tim Robinson grabbing that really semi off the back foot, and they'll take three runs for that.
Road end of this Old Trafford ground is Wasim Akram. Straight from Robinson. The ground that's been saturated by rain, that ball is fairly raced across.
And that's the 50th for England. Come up in 178 balls. Nothing startling, but a good solid performance, just what England wanted. It's important that they're back today out and not lose so many wickets and get in a position to dominate the game. And that's out, there's no doubt about that one. That was again the full length we've been talking about, and probably just been back in a little bit there to Bulathi, but certainly it looks a little bit late on the stroke there.
A little bit late on the shot, and he looked as though he played round it a little. But a wicket that Pakistan really needed. They were beginning to struggle, and that just came back on him a little. A very, very good delivery, may even have just brushed his pad.
Again, that's what we've been talking about. That was the perfect length, drawing you into the forward stroke and then just doing that little bit off the seam so that it does do anything, you have a chance of getting past. England captain now, Mike Gatting, coming in. None of the England batsmen have been in particularly great nick this year. They've not had much cricket, and that will depend on these early batsmen to get rounds. Mike Gatting, a pretty powerful player when he gets going, hits the ball very hard.
Here we can see the fall of the wicket again. Bulathi fairly well forward, and that ball must have come back a little off the seam. Six. And the first wicket put on 50.
Couple of slips in the gully. Cover, extra cover mid off, mid on, mid wicket, long leg, and Madhusudan to Mike Gatting. And he's off
off the mark there. There's no important winner for that. It might be wet outfield, but that's certainly sped away to just behind square on the leg side. The best there on the short stand. There's nothing for sure from this wicket.
This was Slasher Mackay of Australia.
Nice stick. So well timed that not even the damp outfield could stop it. Good shot from Gavin. Down the pitch, I can't believe Madison Zara is trying to test out Gatting on the hook shot or the pull. Simply not quick enough. Oh. Straight by Gatting. No ball called, run by Harold Bird. Oh. Good tracking stroke. Nice to see Gatting coming out at number three again. Take advantage of the good start put up by Robinson and Bilathi. And that's a fine stroke, beautifully timed. That brings Robinson's 50 up, made out of 112. It's a fine 50, no chances, a difficult one early on, but that was all. Lovely stroke from Gatting. Every time Mudassar has wavered in length, either short or too full, Gatting has destroyed him.
Every time a boundary is cracked in this fashion, beautiful stroke from Gatting. Beautiful delivery from Mohsin Kamal has removed the England captain. He's showing the way it deviated off the seam. Gatting knows what happened to it. It's pegged back the off stump. 133 for two in this, the 54th over.
Gatting seemed to have everything under control, but this one coming right through the gate and knocking him over, absolutely comprehensively bowled. And the well-deserved wicket by Kamal.
Getting bowled by Mohsin Kamal for 42, 81 balls, 104 minutes, 6 fours, and Neil Harvey Fairbrother comes out to make his debut in the Test match. I think we can say that there's a slightly nervous smile. Though he's playing in front of his home ground, he has every right to be nervous. It's a marvellous thing to play for your country. 23 years of age, and the crowd here at Old Trafford willing him to do well. It's out. LBW. That was a good delivery. The first two went away from him. The last one came back. Came back in the air, I think. Good delivery from Mohsin Kamal. Hard lines for Neil Fairbrother, but a triumph for Pakistan.
And a good piece of bowling by Kamal. Neil Fairbrother completely deceived by the line, offering no shot and palpably LBW.
Three now. Gower, Botham, and other batsmen to come, but it's Bruce French being sent in as night watchman. Still with 19 minutes to go.